I'm in the 49er gold rush town of Plymouth, California, to meet a gold hunting master whose nugget discoveries are legendary.
Are you Jim?
Yep.
Dave.
I tracked down Jim Eakin after he made headlines unearthing a massive 19-ounce nugget, which he cashed in for a brand new, top-of-the-line F-150 pickup.
How many years you been doing this?
I've been coming out since I was three, four years old.
No kidding.
Now let's go find some gold.
I love it, man.
I worked in the computer industry for a little while, and I loved the job, but I just hated the commute traffic, living in San Jose, working in Mountain View.
This is freedom. It allows you to do what you want to do and have fun doing it. You're not tied to the man telling you what to do.
Jim traded in his desk job for a metal detector, and now spends his time searching where old-timers used to mine.
I don't know if you can see that little thin line across there in the trees. That's an old water ditch.
Oh, okay.
So that's where the old-timers were taking water to hydraulic mine and ground sluice.
Oh.
Well, when they were putting that ditch in, they cut a quartz vein that had gold in it, so they started mining it right there.
No kidding.
So before they found it, the quartz had eroded away, mm-hmm. and that's how the gold is down in these draws.
Okay.
And I'm going over and finding what they missed.
Okay. The history gives you clues, doesn't it?
Oh, yes, most definitely. That's what we're out here for. It's not just the gold. It's the history behind all the people that came here looking for gold before us.
Got it.
This area was once a hub of mining activity. And between 1852 and 1970, it produced nearly $1.5 billion worth of gold. But there was plenty left behind.
What's the most valuable nugget you ever found?
Piece of crystallized gold, and the piece of gold sold for $2.5 million.
Why did it sell for that much?
Because it's crystallized gold, not just a gold nugget. You get a premium on them. It can go up to $1 million an ounce.
Crystallized gold is gold in its purest form, untouched since it embedded in quartz rock millions of years ago. Once the surrounding quartz is removed, it leaves a uniquely textured nugget. It is so rare, it accounts for just 1% of the world's gold.
Got something to show you here.
Whoa, I like this.
Man,
beautiful gold. So how much do you think this is all worth if I were to buy it?
Probably 30,000.
Wow.
This is one of 29 cases that I got. I only got one out of the bank vault. And
you've got
to bring
29 cases similar to
yes.
this? Oh my gosh, that is awesome.
All in, Jim has found nearly $3.5 million worth of gold. That's not bad for a guy who doesn't own a single piece of heavy equipment.
You probably got enough gold, you probably made enough money that you don't have to do this for a living, do you?
No.
Why do you keep doing it?
Because it's the hunt. It's the
know,
thrill
right?
of the hunt.
Pirate Mike Penwell has been a Black Hills gold hunter for over a decade. But I hear he's got an ingenious way to take advantage of the active creeks running through this claim, which I've got to see.
Check that out.
This is your tarp.
And this is the
tarp
old
procedure.
The old tarp. Throw it in the water.
I'm gonna be honest with you.
I'll show you how simple.
Mike, I don't know what the tarp system is.
That's okay, you'll understand the concept. Go and spend your hundreds of dollars on all your equipment. You don't really need
buy a $20 tarp?
$16.
$16.
I'm gonna throw some flat rocks in there. That's it.
You happy with that?
It's a creek.
Okay.
With rocks in it.
Yeah, it is. Where's your gold?
It's gonna get caught in them rocks. Naturally, the gold sits behind the rocks
yep.
in the creek. All I'm doing is imitating the creek.
Yeah.
It's simple.
Mike might be onto something. For $16, he's recreated nature's sluice box, the natural gold catching process of rivers and streams.
5-gallon bucket, boom, gone.
Throw another one on there.
You bet. What do we have none of? Time, right?
Right.
And who wants to jump in the creek and classify every scoop into a bucket and then spoon it through your sluice?
Yeah.
So I'm skipping a bunch of steps.
Okay.
And if you lose a speck or two,
you make up for it in volume.
And you don't really have to babysit it either. You just go back to digging.
Yep, and that gold's gonna get caught right there. Right here's what you call primitive ground sluice. We're kicking some of the big rocks to the side. We're just trying to get the mud broke up, get it gold freed out of here, and wash all the light particles out. Hopefully the gold stays on the tarp.
This system is as simple as it gets and costs about the same as a large pizza.
5 buckets.
You ready to pull it up?
Yeah.
These have we concentrated 5 buckets into this.
You want to try a pan of this?
Sure.
There's a piece. See one already?
I think so.
Heck yeah. There you go. Got Dave turned a piece of gold.
Yeah,
first
I got
pan.
A piece of Black Hills gold.
Woo!
Mike, I gotta say the tarp worked. Look at right there.
Yeah, heck
that ain't
yeah.
Bad. And it took us maybe half an hour.
In 1 year, Mike's tarp and rock method could make you $12,000. Enough money to buy a used truck and still have money left over for a tank of gas. Not bad for a great location and a sheet of plastic.
So what we got here is wire gold, crystalline gold, and then we got gold in the host rock. This is a piece of quartz. Wire gold comes out of the quartz in long stringers. It almost looks like a wire. This gold came out of the quartz, but it's just much bigger. So there was quartz around it. In fact, if you look really close, you can see the white quartz already in there. And that's rare.
Worth over 5 times its weight, I've heard everyday people are literally picking it out of the ground. So I'm starting deep in the Lowcountry to show you where and how you can get some of this rare Southern Shiny on a backyard budget.
So I'm meeting a guy named Bo. He's got a lot of local knowledge. This guy's the real deal. Bo?
Hey, Dave.
What's up?
Same thing, different day. How you doing?
Yeah, I'm good, man. How are you doing?
I ain't gonna complain.
Bo Poteet is a self-taught rare gold expert and mines all over the Carolinas.
Well, that's some of the stuff.
Some pretty stuff. Wow, that's beautiful.
Crystalline gold.
There's crystalline gold. This came from right here?
Right here, yep.
No way.
But that's just the tip of the Carolina iceberg.
Oh, look at that. My goodness, that's heavy. Wow, Bo, that's pretty neat. You probably got 5 ounces of gold in there.
Containing 5 ounces of gold, this quartz ore is worth an impressive $10,000.
Tell you what, I'd go after some of this. There's some money in that.
There's a lot of that yeah. Where that come from.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you do with the gold you sell?
Pay bills. Keep the roof over the head.
All in, Bo has collected more than $400,000 of gold over the years. And by focusing on the rare stuff in this region, you get a big premium for your finds here.
You got all kinds of stuff, Bo. You've been doing this a while.
Oh, wow, yeah.
It's not just gold Bo finds. Known as the River of Gold by the Cherokee, he's often unearthing evidence of their presence.
What do you got there?
That is a soapstone bow.
And this was carved out?
Yeah.
Oh, I can kind of start to see the...
See where the Cherokee used deer antler to carve it. Between 5 to 15,000 years of age.
Is it really? They even kind of left a little bit of a handle there, didn't they?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's the first one I found intact. Now, I've got another one. It's just half.
Yeah.
They come out of the river.
You got rubies, too?
Yes, sir.
North Carolina rubies can be exceptionally valuable. And 4 rubies found in 1990 have an estimated worth of over $90 million.
That's one I started cabbing.
Oh, so you're polishing it up?
Yeah.
What'd you do, just glue it to a stick or something?
Yeah, and put it on a grinding wheel.
Oh,